This was the Kickstart problem one, aptly named Kickstart. What happens in this problem is, you're very fond of reading, you read a lot of books, so you are superstitious that you should start reading at the index of kick and you should end at start. So for example, in this, we've given these sample tests, so you can notice your kick, then when start comes, you'll stop. Also here you can notice again, kick and start. So it's quite a good problem. We observe this problem, we can notice that there is one property to be maintained here. It's to count how many kick start pairs can be made. Okay, so let me show you on the whiteboard now. Okay, first of all, we are given our book, right? And it has all these kind of alphabets, right? Let's see, it has all these alphabets. Now I'll just think of them as numbers. Think of each word as a number, okay? Or let's think of them, all the words that are not of any use to us, we'll just put a cross. Now we have a kick over here, and let's say we have a start here, and we have another kick here. So notice how many pairs can be made. Only one pair, right? For every kick, we have to see if there's a start after it, correct? And we can pair it with that. So one more, let's look at, let's see the example that they gave us, where we have kick, kick. So we have a kick, we have a start, right? X, X, X means all these other alphabets that I don't care about, okay? X, X, and then they had one more kick start over here. How many pairs can be formed in this example? See, think of this like this. In this example, you can form one pair here. Where can you form another pair? With the same K, you can form another pair. See, with the last S. Right? You can form another pair with this last S. Also, now with the next K over here, can you form with this S? Sorry, you can't. Only with this S. So what if I made, okay, two lists, okay? Imagine in my program, I've made just two lists. Indices of kick, that is my starting, right? These are the indices where kick was found. Let's say it's 1, 3, 9. Indices where start was found. Let's do this all in linear time, right? To just find these indices. Indices where start was found, let's say 2 and 13. So let's count how many pairs are possible. First of all, this one is less than the front element of this list, right? It's both lists are sorted, correct? It's like merge sort. So that means this one will form a pair with everybody in this list. So add the list size. Size of the list is 2. Add 2 to your result. Now pop this one. This 3. 2 is smaller than 3, so pop this 2 as well. So now what is the value in the other list? How many ending points for 3? 1. Pop this 3. Now 9, again, 9 is less than 13. So 9 can make a pair with 13 and all elements greater than 13, right? So the size of the list is 1. So you notice in the end, 4 pairs can be made. So coming down to a pseudocode, this comes to for each kick, right? For each kick, let's call them the left boundary, right? While Vule, sorry, Vule. While the right boundary is smaller than you, you cannot make a pair with someone on your left, right? So you keep moving the right boundary while it is smaller. And then finally, what you do is you just, whatever result you are storing, right? You just plus equal to size of the right side list. Let's look at this in my code. How do I exit this? Just show desktop. Here you can see in my code what I've done. First of all, for test cases and all, it's nice to just write this in advance, one solve function. Now look at this. BK is my book. In my book, first of all, find the first occurrence of kick. Then from that position, from one position in front of that, find the next occurrence of kick. So at the end, all the occurrences of kick and their starting positions are stored in L. Luckily, the words kick and start don't overlap, so we don't have to consider anything else, just the starting index. Okay, find the first occurrence of start. While you find an occurrence, keep adding it to the list called R. R is for the right side ending points. And then you search for the next start in front of this start. Now, merge sort step. So for all the left starting points, right, while the right starting point is less than you, you move ahead because those are of no use, correct? Start that comes before kick cannot be counted as a pair. And then what you do is, you just add up the size of the remaining elements into your result. And you return your result. That was our first problem for this kick start. Now what was our second problem? Maximum coins. Square matrix is given, n rows, n columns, cell ij denotes the cell over there, okay, forget all that. Basically, coins are given in a matrix form, okay? You can start on any square and you can move in these two directions. Can anyone tell me what directions these are? Correct. These are nothing but going like this diagonally, right? Upwards or downwards. Now, what do we have to find? We have to pick up maximum coins. So we'll always want to start like in such a way that we can cover the entire diagonal. So we just have to find the maximum diagonal of the matrix, max diagonal. I mean, a very simple program. Still, there are a couple of different ways to do this. You could do what I did and take use of this property. Any position in a matrix, right? Let me draw one nice matrix here. Zero. Oh, I'm in mouse mode. Let me draw one nice matrix here. 0, 1, 2, 3. Look at this 4x4 matrix. Okay, again, 0, 1, 2, 3. This is a 4x4 matrix. And now look at each index. At this index, right, we have 0, minus 0, 0. I'm saying x coordinate minus y coordinate. In a diagonal, this will always stay the same. 1 minus 1, 0. Slope of a line, you can think of it. A special case of slope. 2 minus 2, 0. 3 minus 3, 0. What about 1 minus 0, 1. 1 minus 2 minus 1, 1. 3 minus 2, 1. 2 minus 0, 2. 3 minus 1, 3. 3 minus 0, 3. Sorry, here I meant to write 2. So notice all elements in the diagonal have the same value for x index minus y index. Actually, because y is equal to mx plus c, and if you consider over here what's the case, the special case over here, m is 1 since it's 45 degrees. So you can notice that all these lines have this property basically. Another way to do it would be to go through this list and from each starting point, right, from each position in the first row and first column, you travel downwards. That was a very easy logic. From each position in first row and in first column, just travel downwards. How to travel downwards? Anybody will know this basic logic if you know it. X plus plus, Y plus plus. That will take you diagonally downwards, right, from 0, 0 to 1, 1. So just travel downwards from every position and keep calculating the sum. I mean, code in this case is really basic. What I did is the difference method. So for each difference, j minus I, add up the value, keep storing the result. Problem B really intrigues me. It was I'm not sure why I couldn't solve it. So problem D, merge cards. Okay, I'm not going to go over the question since I did not solve it. So those who have solved this problem, do tell me where my mistake is. Merge cards, I just have to merge two cards. So I prefer to use a list data structure. Why? Because a list is having a good time complexity for arrays and all in the middle. I actually didn't need it in the end. I used it as if it was a vector, so I wasted energy. And then for all these, I start, okay, with the entire list. Then what happens is, I go inside my function, and if my list size is 2, I directly return the sum of both elements along with the sum of all the previous elements, right, in the answer. Now, when I'm calculating probability, I just divide by the list size minus 1, all the sum of all the next answers. I can do it over here as well, since anything, it stays continuous. So I pass these test cases, but I don't pass the real cases. So you can notice my go function. This is how it goes. First, it will merge these two, then it will merge these two, then it merges these two. This is just the see out of the go function, which parameters and what was the returned value. For the first case, it's just directly 20, you get 20, since there are only two cases, two base cases of 2 and 2. So this line of code is add everything before you. This line of code is add the merge values, who you're merging, right? Those two guys, merge them and put it in the new list. Then add the rest of the list like a normal person. And add yourself to result. Clear the list, take from the next point, add the next two values to each other. Just keep merging two values and checking the answer. Samples only pass, only samples pass. Yeah, that's it.